Please understand, it's one of the most basic question about incompletion. First time I am answering this question. This is the most basic science of why, how incompletions are built and why it gets completed when the reliving happens. Your life is nothing but time flowing over the space. If you just keep your space with so much of love, visualize you are holding yourself with so much of love and expansion and bliss and allowing the time to crash you. That is like just such a beautiful flow. It'll be like a snow car driving. You will exactly feel life is flowing through you like that. Snow car driving. And it is more and more exciting, enthusiastic. But whenever you stick your fear and greed into the time, you dent the time. The dented wheel cannot move fast. Removing the dents is completion. How many of you got the answer I gave? If you are a regular satsangi, you will catch it immediately. If you are watching our satsangs, you will catch it immediately. Otherwise, the words I have thrown are little maybe going above your head. How many of you did not understand? Raise your hand. I'll repeat. If you did not understand, please raise your hand. I'll repeat. Listen, I'll repeat. No, I can see Houston, two people did not understand. Here in Bidhi, few. I'll repeat, listen. Visualize your inner space is the road. That nail or a thorn or a stone sticking out of the road is your fear or greed. Your car tire is time. If the time moves smoothly on the space, there is no incompletion. If it moves on the nail or the stone, then your tire becomes flat. You can't move further. So, always if you hold the inner space consciously, without fear and greed, you will never create incompletions. For it to be reality, go back to the incompletions created, where all you put your nail and the stone, relive. So, when the time moves into the space, please listen, you may go back to that same space, same time and relive. But it is happening now. Please understand, you may go back to past, but you are in present. Going back to the past while you are in present is completion. Going forward to the future while you are present is inspiration. What you are going to do, if you visualize, that becomes inspiration when you are in the present. What you have done, if you relive, it becomes completion when you are in the present. You see, when you consciously relive, whenever you become conscious, you will be in the present. And consciously relive, you will suddenly removing all the dents and cleaning up your whole past. The time is healed. Kalabhairava puja is done. Immediately Kalabhairava blesses you with completion. Yes. Next question.
Mukti Rupa has submitted one more question. He's asking, how would a place like Cambodia help completion and root patterns, especially when we do inner awakening in December?
No. Cambodia is no way going to help you in root pattern and all that. It is going to wildly awaken your Kundalini. In the Kundalini tsunami, your root pattern and all is like a small grass. It goes away. The Cambodia is no way built for completion or that root pattern and all that. You may not even hear the word root pattern from me in Cambodia. You may not even hear the word root pattern or completion from me in Cambodia. It is going to be straight. Put this herb in your tongue. Keep it below the tongue. Keep it above the tongue. Inhale through the nose. Come on, Kundalini, tuck. It is going to be an enlightenment pill. You understand? There is no question of concept, theories and all. Keep this herb between your teeth and sit now straight. Inhale through the left eye, exhale through the right ears and Shivoham. You understand? See, the Cambodia is created more for a mass enlightenment. That is, see, this completion and all is leading you to enlightenment through a technique. And in Cambodia, I'm not even planning to use any technique. I'm only going to use herbs and yantras. The direct alchemy, that is why I'm saying, see, when you use these techniques, you will get like a high yield relationship, wealth and all as side effect. But in the Cambodia process, you are going to get some siddhis as side effects. The side effects of those process is going to be siddhis. Not like a healing and not ordinary making money or all that kind. You are going to get siddhis. You may just change your boss mind as you want. And you may just dictate terms to you in a team meeting. If you just go and sit and talk to the investors, and simply they will forget all their points and do what you are saying. You see, how many of you have experienced the moment you come near me, what you want to ask is forgotten, and simply you go back listening to me. You will have this kind of siddhis. Understand? So Cambodia inner awakening is nothing to do with this root pattern, nothing to do with completion. I don't think I will even repeat the word completion or root pattern in Cambodia. And the whole pattern is not going to be this. The whole pattern is going to be like I may make you walk some 3-4 kilometer and then make you sit like in cold water, give you the herb. It is directly going to be working on your body. The alchemy, how the siddhas did yantras and the herbs and experience of Shivoham. It is not going to be, you are not going to be sitting with your mirror and long ago, once upon a time, when I was as my child, my teacher came. No. No question of all that. And I did not even know the word completion or root pattern when I became enlightened. I was given enlightenment through siddhis, through the herbs and yantras. Of course, I was given knowledge, but not like this any process and all that, any techniques and all these methods. So what my gurus have done to me, I am going to do to you guys. That's all. Come on.
The next question is from Laurie in Houston. The question is, I'm having trouble locating the exact source of the main issue. Please advise.
I'm having trouble locating the exact source of the main issue. Listen, Laurie, Houston, Lori, can you raise your hand? Yes, yes, yes. See, in you I can, yes, yes, I can see you and tell you the exact issue. Exact issue is anxiety. Anxiety. See, for example, you will be anxious even for the things which already happened in your favor. For example, you are waiting for an exam result. The exam result came, you passed. Even now, you will not be able to get out of that anxiety you created for exam result. You may want a job, you would have attended the interview. You are now, they would have given the result, you are successful, you got the job. Even after that, you will not be able to get out of that anxiety you created. Understand? You are understanding what I am saying? All I am trying to tell you is, I am not even saying you complete with anxiety which is yet to happen. Complete with all the anxiety which has already happened. For example, you might have been anxious to have a job. You got the job. Complete with that anxiety. You might have been anxious about passing the school exam. You passed. Complete with that anxiety. You may want to have own a house. You may be having it now. Complete with that anxiety. All the anxiety you created, but in which you are successful now, complete with those first. That is the source of your problem. Getting what I am saying? You are able to connect with what I am saying? Great.
The next question is from Hemraj from Toronto Center. When I was doing the mirror exercise, I put down the mirror and followed the chanting that was playing. I saw a shadow of Swamiji walk across the room and then right after saw that a black car hit me down. What can I make out of that?
See, it is one of the deep fear you are carrying has come out. Don't worry, you will not get into any accident. I am here to protect you. But do completion with that fear. Do completion with the fear of getting into the accidents. Hemraj, got the answer? Blessings. Next.
The next question is from Port Washington. Scott, the participant name. So when I write the experience, relive it in the mirror, I feel the emotion repeating itself and I feel bored and distracted and put the mirror down. Why is this?
Port Washington. Scott, can you raise? Yes, listen. That is what you see, completion always makes incompletion powerless. Incompletion naturally doesn't want to lose its power over you. Understand? So even if you feel this way, don't leave, catch. Catch your incompletion, complete at least 5 times, relive at least 5 times, you will see it melts down. It is just little more effort is required, that's all, nothing else. Blessings.
The next question is from Phoenix Zephyrin. Her question is, the experience of reliving an incident was much more real with eyes closed. When looking it in mirror, it felt more like remembering. Can you please share your wisdom on this?
No. I think, you may be a person who dreams more. That is why the closing eyes look better. But it will always be, with open eyes, it will be more powerful completion. Do it with the mirror. That will be more powerful always. Okay, next.
The next question is from San Jose, Jessica. I think this exercise helped me with the completion regarding my relationship that is in a very precarious position right now. Will you please send me blessings and healing regarding moving forward with this relationship?
Jessica, blessings, tatastu. You will be healed.
And the next question is also from San Jose, Alison. I have a pattern of suppressing myself and my emotions and I have always been like this as long as I remember. I think it's because I was adopted, but I don't know how to complete because I was an infant and I don't remember. What is the best way to complete with this?
I think you should become more and more active in everything you do. Even while you are walking, the movements of the hands should become more. Movements of the leg should become more. Consciously add enthusiasm, excitement, activism in everything. You will get out of this problem. See, while you are eating, move your mouth more. While you are breathing, breathe more. So everything, let your body movements be more. Even if you are doing namaste, not like this, like this. You understand? A big namaste. So let your body movements bring more activism, then you will see this pattern will depress, will be completely removed. This pattern of suppressing will completely be dropped. It will die. Even laughing, not like how you are laughing now. Now, fully, the whole body laughing. No, not even like that. You see, like this. Like that. So bring more activism into body consciously, this suppressing pattern will disappear. Thanks. Let's gather for next session. Thank you. Be blissful.